All right, everyone, welcome to the first rehearsal for Chronicle Press Play Record
the Arcadian
recordings. Watch me
observer report. Someone to watch over me. We like that one.
Things we lost in the fire.
Push. Based on recordings.
Spoiler alert. Things we lost in the fire.
Demon eyes.
Chris, it's Michael. Mike, can I come up?
Who?
Michael Danube, your best friend?
Yeah, just don't scare away the birds, man. I'm serious.
Okay.
I'm really sorry about this, Mike.
For what?
Yeah.
Look, I came here to ask you one last time to... Can we just get in my truck and I can take you somewhere?
What?
Alright. Let's take it back. Oh, far back.
Let's go back.
All right, here we are, day one of the tertiary footage of Untitled As of Yet project between me and Justin Benson, my co-director. Say hi, Justin.
Hello.
You want to introduce the crew?
Yes, this is Aaron Moorhead, director of Untitled. I'm Justin Benson, director of Untitled. This is Mike.
I thought that was a picture. Liar! Unenthused.
Where's that 7D?
So here is us driving to location. Them still in their makeup.
Face
looking
destroyed.
Solid.
I'm gonna wipe it off before.
And this, by the way, is the first time that I have ever seen snow falling from the sky. Here is my location. It is the snowiest peak of them all. Justin is currently in there changing the film out. A little snowy, but it's also freezing cold. We've actually already got a couple setups off, so.
This is us winding up the found film of the man finding his lover with their arm blown off in the forest. Justin and I, we just finished making this. We shot it on real 8mm, and with very little knowledge or tools, we did the most analog possible way, where we just cut it. We actually found the frames, cut it with a razor on this knife, marked it, you know, then cut it, and then we did get some of these, but apparently these are supposed to be used with a splicing machine, which we didn't have, so we just very, very carefully put little pieces of that tape on it, if you can see there, on our marks. And we're about to find out if, when we throw it in this projector, it destroys itself. And all this work was for very, very little.
We had it, that property already, and then we talked to Bob. Bob actually sold it to us. He's really shy. Hey, come here. This is the director's quarters at Camp Oliver. This is Justin's side of the room. He's insisted to leave it exactly as is. Coming out of here, see my tiny little car. And the beautiful Camp Oliver.
It's Christmas morning!
But there was a bat in the trailer, and it had been there for a long time, and we'd known it had been there for a long time, and we were very scared of it. And so,
You're scared of that? Oh.
Bats are horrifying when they're inside.
Yeah, we didn't know what was up there.
Really
so Justin,
are.
Basically, all it is. And it's, you know, rubber in there, so.
There's rubber in there.
All right. Lifting the camera.
Plastic.
Choke it up there, so.
And that's it. That is seriously it.
And then it's actually just kind of so secure, you can just kind of let it hang.
Right.
and that's it.
Just in like waiting for that thing to snap.
I know, and I talked to them about
that. I think for Michael's single, I think this corner is going to be safe.
Okay. I think so, yeah.
Because I'm pretty sure I'll have to point into that corner when he's talking.
Basically, Michael runs into two cult members that are probably in some sort of millennial UFO cult. And Aaron and I played those cult members. And
maybe
we're a part of a non-profit communal organization. We're just devoted to restoring the balance between the cosmic children and the prophets in the kingdom that make the heavenly connections. Now,
it's a lot of dialogue.
Yeah, yeah.
But I mean, essentially, our whole thing is just making sure people know that the celestial Messiah will land his vessel before the end of days.
I mean, of course,
before
like,
it's
like before the apocalypse.
I mean, I know
it's kind of hard to grasp at first, but
yeah.
How you doing up there, Dan?
Good.
Can I get some nice clean sound?
Comes back. Where did you get that? Saw the blah 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 teeth. Following him. Okay, so I will follow him over. Okay. So we'll cross the front. And then basically, whip past everyone. We don't use that piece.
And boom.
Cool. That's that.
Cool.
Understood that you hate that.
Look off into the distance and think about the frailty of life.
Oh my God, are we about to make a black hole?
You are like a plastic bag in the wind right now. Even Carmela is going to come and go as she pleases, pretty much. I mean, we can shoot. This scene has to be edited with a wide and two singles. We can start shooting. Definitely his single. If she's still not here,
yeah.
Let's look at it. There's some more we can get.
Yeah. I just learned something.
Mm-hmm. Or realized it.
Yeah.
Thumbing through one's script as the director is the equivalent to walking around with your shoulders in front of you as a group when you really don't have anything else to do.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm
working.
Yeah.
Especially
it's the same as, you know, that light stands somewhere.
Yeah.
I'm plugged in, here's the other end.
So happy God made the roads wet for tomorrow. It's going to look like a Michael Bay Toyota commercial.
Yeah, she's going to be so beautiful. I hope it lasts.
I do.
Look at this massive thing over here. You may have discovered the heating. This is a big moment for behind the scenes. Oh, it's air conditioner. Don't turn that on.
Dan, check the cave for harmonics for us so we don't have a cave-in. Go ahead.
Oh my God, look at my face.
Look at that.
It's terrible.
Look at that close shave. Ooh.
Oh,
I love
God,
that you
right
called
here.
That you're going to totally have like nicks and razor burn.
Yeah.
No,
I want them to see it. Like, that's like funny to me. Like that I'm like, yeah, come on, man.
It does look like someone took a dull hatchet to your face.
Did you use shaving cream?
I did.
Okay.
Yeah. It's rough. It's just my beard does not want to come off. It loves me.
Yeah, this cult has very few rules. I mean, we have the same rules that most millennial cults have. Except one must be wearing certain semi-formal garb, such as a white button-down shirt, khaki pants, nice shoes. Sensible, but nice.
Very stylish.
Yep. I get to wear this turtleneck thermal underneath my white button-down shirt because I'm the elder and the most educated in the teachings.
As opposed to these guys over here.
Yeah,
they're in
We'll Aaron's pretty close to getting to where the turtleneck thermal. But
but he can't shave.
Yeah.
That's signifying his leadership.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, we got that. Oh yeah, we got it.
Aaron, what do you think of this? This is hilarious to you, Pete.
Playing a meth addict and eating carbs.
Uh-huh.
It's crunchy.
No, it might have been 80.
It was like... Anyways,
there's more vitamins that way.
It's honestly, it's gonna be the first shot we do tonight.
It's just this plus five. Yes. Like an insert and then.
No, here's the whole shot. So, basically, we are back there by the rocks. Yeah. That's where camera is. And our two characters, Chris and Michael.
Yeah, they're hiding.
They're hiding back there. Mm. And that's where this entire thing takes place from. So again, it's very far away.
Okay.
And we're kind of seeing it from their point of view. It's like over two shoulders.
Right. You see the mess smoke and everything, and Billy and Micah come in here.
Yeah, Charles comes walking up
with his crony. They come in, and Billy and Micah in here are smoking it up in here after. And basically, Charles shoots Billy over here, splatters in the window, Micah runs out, shot the Micah head, lands there. But all of this, everything takes place from those rocks over there tonight. But when we shoot the second half of this scene in two nights from now, we'll be closer up. They're gonna walk up here, we'll be much closer, and we'll have to get obviously much more in detail with that. But for tonight, we're just trying to, from very far away, have it register as there's been some damage.
Okay. Back.
Jokes now, it's finally happening.
Oh, you can't see me! You can't see me!
Before, let's do it. Because I do like the idea
of like maybe Michael trying to ride that tractor when he's bored.
Hey, Melissa.
Deeper.
I'm just putting this on the rock, okay?
D-clutch.
What's up?
I myself, when
you take my glasses off,
too much. But if it's faster getting to the flashlight part, where he's, oh, he might be high again, I'm going to pull out a flashlight quickly to just speed up the scene, I'm into it. But if he's already.
You just came out of this.
I would, I actually personally really would have two flashlights. One that I keep on my body, one I keep
exploring.
I don't believe so.
No. Hurts. Wait, why does your head hurt?
A splitting headache. I don't know. Maybe I got bit by a bug or something. I don't even know. I haven't looked yet.
That's pretty bad, man.
Yeah.
You should get that checked out.
Fuck.
Oh, man.
Ew. Can you come take a look at our head?
Yes, actually, just thought. I love it.
Copy that. Do you feel like it's built up enough that it'll play?
Super easy because he
he's in the doorway. Yeah.
Sorry.
But maybe we'll just get Billy.
Charles first on that. There.
Oh. All right, everyone back to one.
So I won't grab audio cast.
you have enough labs out there?
Nothing much, Jesse.
You're yelling very loud. Oh, wait.
Whatever vocalization you make.
Dinner time.
Is that the
follow-up
painting?
Either
is.
That was just mine.
It's a lot of glass.
Hey, well,
so that basically comes down to
my phone.
Yeah.
You don't want to smoke that.
Come on. I'm behind the camera. I'm in front of the camera.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll let you know. I'll keep you. Go to town. You can hold on to the lighter.
Yeah, totally.
Either Glenn or Bob is the one. We'll have the brown bag and then the other one will have.
Yeah. Perfect.
So they're all set, probably in 5 or 10.
All right.
Glenn's awesome.
He is awesome.
He's gonna be.
They're
perfect.
Both gonna. Look.
Yeah, they're gonna be perfect.
They look.
Wow.
They look. Couldn't perfect. Have done better if we cast. Production is a little. You know, I mean, the PA we've got is a. I think he's a bit off.
It's a little bit off.
Yeah.
It's off. Yeah. This is me coming to get you for the set.
This is my trailer. It's pretty low budge.
This
I drove
is
here
nice.
Myself.
It can be like post-rain, you know? It just can't be. This might still be a little bit too wet.
We'll just see if it gets any better and if we're just waiting here and it just doesn't get any better, you know?
I mean, we've only been waiting for half an hour.
Yeah, this isn't bad.
Well, it's almost 6 p.m. What's gonna happen, guys?
Wait, really? What, how close are we? Let's do something for the rapture.
We should probably do something for the rapture party. It is... Oh god, it's 6:06. We're all still here.
Damn it.
Wait, who's gone? Guys, get a head count. Who's gone? It's 6:06.
You guys, head count. Head count. We're 6:06.
Vinny's gone!
That was unexpected.
Don't step on rattlesnakes. Don't, careful rattlesnakes. Don't bring food outside of the kitchen. Just keep all the food down the kitchen. And be discreet with any kind of, like if you smoke or you drink, totally fine. I'm sure they expect it. Just be discreet with it because they're technically a Christian camp.
Justin and I have been working on this for a pretty long time. And we're trying to make this movie very, very upfront and honestly and just kind of in a way that is conducive for all of you guys to take a part in it in whatever way you want to. Obviously, beyond the roles that we've brought you on as. So, you know, feel free to, you know, we have a tiny little crew, so feel free to just step up, say whatever, you know, talk to us. And then also, in terms of, like, general production and accommodations and stuff, let us know if there's something that you want or need. You know, we'll tell you if we can't, but don't keep quiet about it. Just ask us, you know, and we'll kind of figure it out.
Especially regarding food.
Yeah.
Like, well, there's a ton of stuff in there for breakfast, but if you feel like there's something else you'd like, just let me know and I'll get it for you guys. And then as far as the food we're getting served for lunch and dinner, again, like if you feel like something's missing and you're just not getting the calories you need because you just can't bring yourself to eat what you're getting.
I need lobster every day.
Done?
Awesome.
Get out.
They call him Scorpion Moorhead. The sequel, part two.
That was part of our strategy of covering up the stuff we can get clear. It's just drawing all over it, and this will be used in court against me.
Hold on that camera tight. If you hit a rut, yeah.
I'm good. Gone.
Right now, you're heading to...
Oh, shit. I'm almost thinking walking is a better choice.
The story, which is an abandoned gold mine on this property. The cameraman who's filming right now is in the only vehicle that we have that'll make it to the mine. And there's not enough room, so we're walking. The talent is walking. Bullshit, right?
No, it's cool, Dan. Sound guy can needs to ride. I mean, I'm a delicate individual. No, you're the set fuck up.
I hope it goes away.
Is there fresh coffee?
Yeah, there's coffee. Have you checked the thermos lately?
No, I haven't.
Okay, there should be some in there. If not, I got another pot already over there.
Thanks. You're the best.
Hey, no problem.
Let's do the scene, though. Bullshit.
Okay.
Hey, man.
Yeah. Like your head's
right there. What are you doing?
Going from behind the scenes. You want to be in behind the scenes?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there you go.
Can you see a bug bite here?
That was shot on three cameras. That was shot with the HVX, DVX with the anamorphic adapter, and a T2i HDSLR.
Nice.
But Aaron put a filter on it that probably made it. That's probably what you thought the 8mm was.
Editing day two, I guess day three. It is 6:30. Not sure if I saw the outside today. Oh, no, I did. I weeded the garden. But currently working on scene 49, watching some dailies. Tried a little color timing, see if I could make it look like dusk. I'm so lonely. Now August 1st.
It is August 1st.
We are going on how many hours at this point? 6, so 18. No, that was... Yeah, 18.
CD.
Yeah. I believe we're 118
minutes in. 118
minutes in? Yes.
It's pretty solid. Wait, no.
We're not?
1 hour and 18 minutes.
Yes.
So... far less than 118. 22.
32. It's hour 32 of the mix. It's going strong. But got a rat.
I can't figure out why or how to turn it off.
Alright.
Like, this is supposed to be kind of creepy and kind of get your attention.
I really feel like we are now at the point where every good idea the three of us could have had in the last, like, 4 months is, like, it's on screen. Or mm-hmm. in the speakers, rather.
Is this thing on? How do I... Oh, there, it's on, guys.
You ready? Is that what Dr. Dre uses?
It's not.
One, two, ready...
This is the making of the second poster, the second of quite likely what will be five or maybe six posters. We're trying to decide what thingy is going to go above the title right there. There'd be a thingy.
Because if it's smaller, you'll be able to tell. You know, like closer up, you'll be able to tell what it is. You know?
So like from... We've decided on I after it was initially penis. Is this that analog thing you were talking about? Organic analog?
Yeah, I was saying organic, saying to split the difference.
Mm-hmm. Split the difference in the organic and the analogness.
Yeah, it's analog.
I can just fit myself in.
Wait, I'm not in the, I'm not
all
in
right, the right. And this is our first film festival of the season, or the run.
Yep.
And the plan is we'll take one of these at every film festival. And then we will edit all these together, and they will be fascinating.
And ideally...
Fascinating.
You're going to see all of us lose all our hair.
Yes.
And all our money.
All our money.
And there's slowly less of us until it's just Justin.
We'll have to barter for things using stuff from our gift bags to survive.
Which is fine.
To survive.
That's the filmmaker's life we've committed to.